Hello!
Hi.
We're on to episode 2 now.
We're on episode 2, The Devil's Chord. Very excited about this episode.
Me too.
Music. There's a lot of... There's so many ongoing themes so far already.
There's a lot of mysterious characters too.
Yes.
Like, a lot of them.
And a lot of theories about who they are and what their purpose is. And I've got my own and you've got yours. And what's her name?
Jinx Monsoon. Can I just say, right, I don't like drag shows or anything like that. I'm not into that. I'm gay, before you think I'm a homophobe, if you've not tuned into this channel.
Anyway.
I don't know. I'm just scared. Don't hate me. However, the actor, it's Jinx Monsoon, isn't it? I think that's the real name.
Well, that's what you told me. You said she's pretty sure that's right. Drag Race.
Yeah, she won. I know she won that.
Right.
The actor who plays this character, from what I've seen, I think she's going to be wicked. And I mean that in more ways than one.
In every single possible way.
And just to top this off, right, this is probably going to be the closest that we're going to get to a musical got through episode.
Aside from the goblins.
Yeah, but that was the one thing.
There's another long-running theme, it's like music.
Connections to music.
Obviously, there's been that whole thing about maestro, obviously being
master,
Latin for master. But, and I believe it is the master, and I think the majority of people don't really think that. From what I've seen on Who Culture, anyway.
Anyway, let's shut up. God, the woman who keeps turning up.
That doesn't help me.
It does. Isaac Newton woman, the pub woman.
That woman could be anybody.
The amount of time you've had this conversation.
And I lived there with my granddaughter Susan.
Oh, Susan!
Okay.
You're what?
My granddaughter.
Susan.
We could go and have a look, but you know, timelines.
Go and have a look! Cause this villain.
And music is mine.
Oh my god. This person, if her name's Jinx Monsoon, IRL. Amazing performance. Absolutely amazing. Oh, you clever, clever person.
Mate, how good was that?
That was amazing.
I've never seen anything like that before. I tell you what, there's a lot more to this story than I actually thought.
I thought it was
just going to be about who's the mum, but who's Ruby?
Oh God, yeah.
This is what we wanted.
Can you find the lost chord?
No!
Yeah, but now there's a piano in a hallway. Somebody's gonna play it.
Beatles!
You see a piano, you can't not play. Yes!
Beatles!
That's what's gonna happen.
Yes! Ruth's back, baby.
Oh, isn't it just?
Wow. That.
That was something else.
Way up there. Way up there.
That was something else, that was.
Like, Wild Blue Yonder, that was something. That's at the top since coming back.
Oh my god, that's, you know what, mate? That was ten times better than Wobbly Yonder.
Really?
You know how much I love
I can't believe that.
Because it was so... I mean, Wobbly Yonder was intricate.
Yeah.
In a different way emotionally, but this was intricate.
Because
it affected everybody in the world.
Those
ordinary people going to their windows. And
that was a really magical scene, though, to be fair.
Yeah, and then that lady... I just realised what happened to the lady.
The old lady.
Maybe she got saved.
She might, I don't know. I mean, that boy was there.
Yeah.
Well, I'm just going to shit on that for a moment, because I've just thought... At the start of the episode, that little boy was Jinx Monsoon's Maestro's son.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, that's also reminded me that, the character's called Maestro, not Jinx Monsoon. Yeah.
So what if that the son, that kid might be the one who waits? Keep hearing about the one who waits. Just theorising.
I don't think I've heard much about it.
I said it in this one, and I said it in The Giggle. Neil Patrick Harris said that the one who waits, and he said that's someone else's game.
Oh, I remember that.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So, just someone coming in. I don't know who it is, but I'd be disappointed if it were a little kid, though, compared to Neil Patrick Harris and Jinx Monsoon.
It's the goldfish from BGT.
It is. It's... Do you know what? If you don't live in Britain, you won't have a clue what's that. Jim the Fish. Next episode looks boom.
That's going to be a real change of pace and a change of... Because it looks very serious.
Yeah. And I'm so excited for Moffat to come back. That's next week. Moffat.
Dare you to go and knock on his door and say Moffat.
They probably won't even open it to me, to be fair.
No, actually, you won't get the gates. To be fair, I know a lot of people do say Moffat. It's just wrong.
Fuck off.
In my humble opinion.
Well, shall we take a step out of the TARDIS and into Eurovision now?
Yes, it is time for Eurovision. And ain't nobody getting in the way of our Eurovision.
It's our thing. So we're going to cut this short because I'm so excited for that as well. It's our night tonight, isn't it, mate?
I mean, it's been an extra surprise for me because I'd completely forgotten that we were watching a second episode of Doctor
Who. Really?
Yeah, totally. I said that to you as we were doing the outro. I was like, I didn't even know we were watching a second one. Remember now, but...
Yeah. I totally didn't even realise you said that, to be fair. Yeah. Anyway, we're going to go because it's Eurovision time now. So these reactions will probably be out on Sunday.
Hope you enjoy them. Flags up.
Yeah, I've still got them, mate.
There's a flag. We've got all the flags.
All
the nations that enter. Don't know about the whole Israel thing.
It just goes on forever. It literally does.
Are you a magician? You have sleeves on.
Do you know what?
Could have pulled this out and it would have gone on forever. I would have,
that would look so cool as well. I'll get you next year.
You need to do that to somebody.
Anyway, party time for us, and I hope you enjoyed these. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.